All right, enough of that. Let's get going. All right, boys and girls, this is our very last stream, regular season stream. Our very last regular season for the Cardinals franchise. So this is our last monthly stream. So month of September. After this, it'll just be playoffs. So we'll either have one more stream, two more streams, or three more streams, depending on if we can win the first round of the playoffs, win the LCS, and get to the World Series. So yeah, this is our last regular season stream. And we got to win 24 games. We got to go 24-4 to get to 100 wins. We won 100 games or more 3 years in a row. So, might be a tough task. This is also we've won four straight division titles, so we're going for our fifth straight. And you can see right there, we only have a two-game lead over the Pirates because we've been not playing as well as of late. So we need to get hot at the right time and fight off the Pirates. Pirates, Phillies, and Brewers are in the wild card lead. That's the American League. Astros, Guardians, Orioles, and their wild card is the Twins, Rays, and Rangers with the Yankees a half game back. So, anyway, that is where we are. I did do a couple of transaction things. Not that it really matters. I added two pitchers to the 40-man and moved Luke and Baker off of the 40-man. I also, as you can see, I signed Joan Duran to a one-year deal, 18.9 for 1 year. I didn't realize I paid him $18 million. I didn't think I did. Nolan Gorman, five-year contract. Royce Lewis, three-year contract. None of that matters because we're only going to play this year, but that's for me because I will keep playing off-camera once we're done. So, anyway, September call-ups. Let's see. Did that say? Okay. All right. September call-ups. We've got, I don't need any more pitchers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I probably could call up another pitcher. Don't know that I need to. Don't need an extra catcher right now. Don't want to mess with those guys down there either. Though we could bring, I can improve our defense. Carter Jensen. Sheldon Parks is just not hitting high enough. I mean, he's hitting 268, but he'll just waste away on our bench. I'd rather have him play in the minor leagues. Same thing there and there. Yusnil Colon, he's hot. It was our first round pick 2 years ago. What do we want to do? What do we want to do? I don't want to bring up anybody, to be honest. Should have done this off camera. So let's just bring up a catcher. We'll put Páez double A. We'll put this guy in triple A. And we'll bring this guy up to the majors. All right, now we have three catchers. And we'll bring up Zach Thompson. All right, done. Let's see. All right. So we are definitely playing a game against the Pirates here, and we'll probably play a game at the Reds here, and we'll sim all the rest. And, we might do quite a few more player locks just to have a little bit more impact in some of these games. But we're going to get through and get this, this season over with. Carlos Vargas, what is he? Is he a lefty or a righty? Don't know who this guy is. Right-handed. Okay. All right. Well, let's jump in and we'll do a player lock right off the rip. And let's go back to Nolan. I can keep trying to get Nolan rolling. Need to get him going for the playoffs. Really doesn't matter, because once we get to the playoffs, then everything's going to reset, and the guys that were hot are no longer going to be hot, and the guys that were cold are no longer going to be cold. So, anyway, I have a poll over on my Discord for anybody that hasn't voted. How many votes? I think we only got like two votes right now. Three votes. I asked, once we're done with this Cardinals season, once we're done with the playoffs, do you want me to relocate the A's to Salt Lake City, rename them the Utah Avengers with new uniforms and a new ballpark, and try and build that team up? Or do you want me to just grab the White Sox and rebuild them and move them to a new custom stadium? Either one of those two options, I'm going to take the latest live roster. I've already got it downloaded. I've already tweaked it a little bit, edited some of the prospects that were drafted in July that they have rated too low, and moved some guys that were starting pitchers that they have listed as relievers and vice versa. So I'm going to use that. So it's going to have players based on this point in the major league season. So sup, CMG, doing good. How are you? But that's what we're going to do, is one of those two. Right now, it's 2-1 to relocate the A's. I'm going to tell you right now, if we do the A's, I'm going to trade a shit ton of players away, so I don't basically have the same team that I did when I started the A's franchise last year. I'll keep some guys, but I'm gonna make a bunch of trades and try and build my own roster and not try to do so much through the draft and everything. But yeah, CMG, doing good, man. I have two high school playoff matches tomorrow for volleyball, and then I'm done reffing until January, I think, club. So we'll be doing a lot more nighttime streaming. Uninstall CMG, I played it 3 weeks, I think. 3 weeks. And it's off my PlayStation. I totally uninstalled it back in early September. The game is garbage. I really want to play football, but I'm not going to go back to 14. And I'm not playing that piece of shit game. Yeah, I have been so much calmer and not raging playing video games. I mean, this game will still make me rage from time to time, but that game just drives me to drink, so I'm done. Get down. That ball was in the air way too long. I know the football is more popular on my YouTube channel by a wide margin. The views are not even close to the same, but I am not going to play that game. Ah. Yep, I know. It's terrible. It's a flat garbage game. They told us it was going to be great, and they lied. It's college Madden, and anybody else that disagrees with that is fooling themselves. It's broken just like Madden. It's just broken in different ways. That was a terrible at bat. Fucking terrible at bat. There we lose. We should lose. Yeah. That game is, it's not fun. And the guys in the NWO, they can't even get a full game played without a disconnect. I've like the last three or four times I've tried to watch them play, the game disconnects even when they're not even streaming the game. Like I was in Discord with the guys watching Snossages and Jimmy Two Buns play each other, and the game disconnected with like 2 minutes left. It's just terrible. All right, we just had a catcher get hurt. What do I have? Who can I get rid of? This guy hasn't played all year. You're released. I need a catcher for the minor leagues because they just got a catcher get hurt. Right, he is signed. And let's see, Crooks is in double A, so you're going to double A. There we go. All right. Tinkinson, Ronzi Contreras, and we sim and win 4-1. All right. Mason Winn with a home run. Tink only goes five, but gets his 11th win. Duran with his 31st save. Romero is 31st hold. Where are we at? 3.5 game lead. Okay, good, good, good. And Manoah and Peterson. And we get a 3-2 win. So we win two out of three. Naylor with a home run. Manoah pitched great. Sandlin gets his 10th win in relief. All right. I think we're going to pitch this game with Andrew Painter because I think I've only pitched with him once all year. But we're going to player lock. Yeah, that game is just garbage. It's not fun. It's not fun. I watch all of the shit that people post on Reddit about just the terrible things that happen, and I am just amazed that people still play that game. I know you want to play a football game, but man, it's bad. Let's go with Jordan Walker. Oh, let's go, let's go. No score. In real life, the Cardinals would be wearing blue sleeves and a blue hat. Anytime they play a team that has red, they switch to their navy blue sleeves and navy blue hat. And for whatever reason, MLB The Show does not have that uniform option in here. Ah, jammed. Right, still no score. One, one out. Nice pitch. Well, I try to hit that. There's just going to be a ground ball at third base for double play. So, need something up like that. Is that going to be off the wall, maybe? Or over the wall? Yes. Adios, there we go. It's 25th. He's trying to get 30 bombs. There we go. Boom. Didn't pause it. I can get a replay later. I got to make sure I take a picture for thumbnail. He'll catch that one. I kind of jammed myself. All right, can we hold this 2-0 lead? Come on, boys. All right. 6-run lead. So Jay-Z with a homer. There we go. Michael Wacha is in relief. Yeah, we'll stay off that. Oh, I created a custom stadium for Utah, but I'm working on an additional custom one for that, like a 2.0. Yeah, not 100% Sure, I like it. It's like it's 75% there, but it's not all there. It's always the sex out in the outfield close to the batter's eye that gives me the biggest problem with trying to be something I like. All right, big 7-0 win. Cutliff goes 9. Walker and Sajazy with homers. Cutliff is 14-4 with a 5-hit shutout. There we go. Cutliff was our very first-round pick of this franchise. All right, Bybee and Brandon Williamson. Another left-handed pitcher. Let's go Mason Winn this time. We got Noda. Alcantara, Logan Driscoll. You guys different. So if we end up moving the A's, I'm going to keep Rooker. I'm going to keep Mason Miller. I'm going to keep some of their young players, but I'm going to be looking to reshape that team how I feel like it. And since it's in Utah, it's at altitude. It's over 4,000 feet altitude. We need some power hitters to hit the ball over the fence. And we need strikeout pitchers. Regression reversal for baseball. I do it with some people, not all of them. I wish they would fix it so it's they don't just drop off a cliff after they get 10 years of service or hit 30 years old. There's plenty of guys that play. Yeah. You know, the biggest thing that they do, you should go look at the first baseman and see how much their arm regresses. I don't know why a first baseman's arm would regress, but they crush the first baseman by knocking down their arm. And if you push their arm back up to 50 or 60, they'll go up 2 points overall. I had to do that with Rhys Hoskins and Goldschmidt. It's ridiculous how bad their arms regress. And they don't throw enough for their arm to regress, right? They need their durability to go down. They need their speed to go down. They need their, you know, there's a lot of things that they need to work on. Is that out here? Yes! Donnie with a home run. But yeah, they'll have good seasons and their contact and power will go down. It makes no sense. They need to implement a system just like Madden does for their regression and progression, where you can tell it how much to go up or down based on age and things like that. That's the one good thing that Madden added. Yeah, Trout, get this. Trout has not played a full season in like the last 6 years in major leagues. Hasn't played a full season, and yet his durability is like 95. On the last roster update, he had like 95 durability. Yeah. And you go into the draft. When you draft players, definitely go look at their durability, because you might have a guy that you think is a absolute stud, and he's got like 35 durability. That's an automatic push up into the 80s, automatically. I mean, there are some guys that are injury prone that are, you know, prospects, but they shouldn't be a 35 and be a first round pick. Oh, he went and got that and hit at Apo Taco. Number 20 on the year for Mason Winn. Let's go. 20 bombs for Mason. Poor Mr. Hurricane. Sadly misused him. He hasn't played second base. The dude's going to win a Gold Glove as a rookie. He just won one of the highest rated defensive rating, defensive awards as a rookie. That's just somebody who doesn't know the Cardinals and doesn't know our players. So we'll just chalk it up to that. Mike Trout, 3-for-4. Mason Winn has 41 doubles and 20 homers. There we go. Gorman with 3 RBIs, got 85. Trout's got 74. Winn, 88. Naylor, 89. There we go. Bybee was okay. Mason Miller sucked. Matsui sucked. But we still got the dub. You know, we have 8 runs in the last 3-4 innings. 3 of the last 4 innings. It was 10-1, and then when our pitching just fell apart. All right. Cabrera pulled calf. Yeah, whatever. All right, we're up to 80. So if we win this, we're guaranteed to have a winning season. And now our lead is up to 4.5. We've added 2.5 games to our lead because it was 2 when we started this. So, there we go. All right, we're going to play this entire game. I want to pitch with Painter. The only thing is, if we don't play this whole game, I could pitch the whole game with Painter. And then we could play another full game. Because I want to play a full game against the Pirates. There's so many home games in the middle. That would mean not playing one until we get to the Cubs. What's the standings look like? Brewers and Cubs are out of it. So, Reds are out of it. Got the Braves and the Mets and the Twins. Braves and the Mets are out of it. Twins are number 1 wild card. Let's play the Twins instead. All right, so I'm going to player lock on the pitcher because I want to pitch with Painter. And then we'll do some other player lock, individual player locks, and then we'll play a full game against the Twins at home, and we'll play a full game against the Pirates at home. All right, this might be a lot of player locks. I stopped putting timestamps on YouTube for all the different stuff. I'm not going to do it. Not enough people were watching it, so I wasn't going to kill myself, so... So now I'm forcing them to go through it. Hey, CMG, have you ever heard of the game? I know Stratomatic, a lot of people heard of because of Keith Hernandez and all that. Stratomatic, APBA, which is APBA, APBA, Stratomatic. There's another game called Diamond Mind Baseball. Here. Google that. I play, that's a computerized game, and I've been playing 30 game seasons where everybody plays 30 games, so a fifth of a regular season. I split them up into smaller divisions, and I've got completed seasons from 1927 through 1966. In 1969 through 2004, 5, 6, somewhere in the early 2000s. All those seasons played. I've got the 67 and 68 seasons left, and that will close the whole gap. I've got all the career stats for all the players in 2 separate spreadsheets. I've got all the team records, how many times they made the playoffs, won the World Series, all that good stuff. It's not like out of the park because you're not playing into the future. I'm always playing with the previous season. But that's why we made it our own little universe and moved the teams around and condensed, went to a bunch of 4, maybe 5 team divisions. You basically play everybody 3 times. Play everybody in your division 3 times home and away, and then play the other teams once 3 times. But it's fun. There we go. No, it's a PC game. It's just a regular PC game. You can go to their website, buy it, install it. You don't need Steam or anything else. They have season discs. They're like $30 for a season. You probably spend, I don't know, $90 in a game, and then each season's like $30. But I won a fantasy league one year, and I bought like 10 seasons worth all at once. Dropped like $300. But I've been buying seasons a little bit as we go. Some of the seasons we played with cards and dice, playing APA. I had to do all the stats on graph paper. That was back in high school and college. Once I got a computer, I was like, fuck that, we're just going to play it. One thing I did do with that game, though, is I replayed the entire 1961 season, both leagues, 162 games for all of the teams in both leagues. Took me several months. So when I was first married, drove my wife absolutely insane because the printer, we had dot matrix printer, and I was printing out the box scores, and that thing just never stopped running. Get to the bag. There you go. So. And they've got overlays of the ballparks, but I have these color images, like from out of the park. Has the color background image of the park. I've stolen some of those off their message boards and some other places, but no, it doesn't. Each individual season is contained in itself. You have to buy each season individually. It's just that one season. So the fun thing is you can either do, you know, like a 30 game season like I did, or you can play a whole 162. There's something I would like to do since I have all the discs is go back and not do the Carlton and Wise trade. Flip them back to the Cardinals and the Phillies and keep Carlton on the Cardinals for the rest of the time he played with the Phillies and see how differently it would have played out for the Cardinals throughout the rest of the 70s and into the 80s if we had Carlton. Because we probably would have won, well, we would have won in 82 anyway, but we probably would have won in 81, the strike year. And probably would have gotten there in 73 and maybe 74. Definitely 73. Mets would not have won that division. So there's a lot of things you can do, the what ifs. You can also play guys across era. So if you want to bring, you know, 1927 Babe Ruth and bring him into the current era, you can like import him into your season and plop him on the Yankees instead of Judge or Stanton or whoever and play a whole season and see how he does. Because the stats are based on era. They actually have a tab that's called era and it goes through the league averages for runs and batting average and all that good stuff. So you can play guys in different eras and see how they would play. Because, you know, back in like the early 1900s, they never had relief pitchers. Guys would throw 400 innings on the mound, right? So that would never happen now. And trying to bring that guy forward. Yeah. That game it's fun. It's just text-based. There's no audio. But I enjoy it a lot. I've gone through stretches where I'm like playing the living shit out of it. And then I've gone 3 or 4 years and not touching it at all. Get him. Throw it. There we go. That was going to hit me. But And when guys get traded, so say in Major League, some dude gets traded halfway through the year, I will put those guys on the team they ended the season with and let them play the whole year with the team they ended the season with, except if it's like one of those, like right at the end of the deadline and they barely played with the new team and it would just crush their old team to not have them for most of the season. I'll just put them on their old team and leave them. Unless it's like an even trade where two batters were swapped for each other, I'll go ahead and let them stay. And I have to go through and figure out how many starts, because I need to total up a total of 30 starts for all their pitchers. So if a trade will mess up and make me play a bunch of guys that, you know, should only get one or two starts in a year, I don't want to give them four. So I'll put them back on their old team. Or if a guy played on multiple teams and he had most of the season playing with one and he only had a handful of appearances with the other two, I'll put him back in his original team. This guy right here, Driscoll, played with Kenny Piper this year in AAA at Durham Bulls. Finished the year up with Tampa Bay. And they also have some franchise all-star things, so you can have all the best players on each one of the teams, which is kind of fun if you want to do like a tournament. Yeah, they put out a season, I think, from 27 all the way up through last year. The new seasons usually come out in December. There we go. Yeah, you can just go to the website. They got all the seasons. You can buy all the seasons you want there, buy the game. Look at this. I'll take these low pitch innings. There we go. I do realize what is going on with this game. I'm not oblivious to what's going on. I'm just having fun chit-chatting and mindlessly pitching. Ah. That's a foul ball. Let's see if I can get this cutter in here. Popped it up. All right. We are through four innings with a 3-0 lead. I wouldn't say it's better. It's a different game. So out of the ballpark, you got all that control where you do the drafts and everything, and you do all the signings and trades and all that good stuff. So if you like that type of general manager stuff, out of the ballpark is going to be the best one. This is just, you know, you play the games. We started using this game. Well, we started with APA. But we had draft leagues back in high school and college. So we get a bunch of buddies together and we would draft a National League team and draft an American League team. And then we would play head-to-head against each other. Hey, I didn't say it wasn't good. I didn't even say it. It's a totally different game, Man Cave. Welcome in, too, man. It's a totally different game. So I wasn't going to even compare the two. I didn't want anybody to think they were, because if you want to do the general manager stuff, Alabama Park is the game. This one is just if you want to play past seasons, or if you want to play head to head against your buddies, like do a draft and put your own team together. My American League team used to have my pitching staff. I had Randy Johnson, Roger Clemens, and Mike Mussina. I was all about Baltimore Orioles baseball. Pitching, defense, and three-run homers. I love three-run homers. There we go. Love three-run homers. They make up for a lot of mistakes. But It's just a different game. It's fun. I mean, like I said, it's a computerized version of like Stratomatic. You know, they've got their stats against lefties and righties. It's got all the advanced metrics and shit in there. So if you want to get nerded out, you can. Ah, come on. See if he likes his changeup. Oh, he's going to reach. There goes the perfect game. 3-2 changeup. Had a perfect game going, and we lose it. He tried really hard. If you didn't see my Rockies series, you can go there, go to my YouTube page, go to my Colorado Rockies playlist, and go to the second season and go to the LDS against the Cardinals, Game 5, Aaron Nola. We threw a perfect game on camera to win the series. And I lost my fucking mind. Let me see if I can find that. See if I can find my clips. There we go. Yeah. Skip all, I don't care. Let's see. Fuck off. Let me see my clips. Clips I've created. No. Clips of my channel. Give me 1 second. Come on. Share. Copy link. Here you go. If you want to see me lose my shit. There it is. For a good reason, not for a bad reason. Oh, that's a rocket. That's going to be off the wall. Kind of hung that curveball to Ellie. Oh, it's Alcantara. They look the same. You going to catch that? Yep, and he's going to stay at second. There we go. Good. Ooh. Knock that down, throw him out. Keeps him at second base. Two down. Ball. Here we go. Shut out through six. Only allowed one hit. I'm sorry, two. Two hits. Forgot about the little infield hit that second baseman tried to knock down. Couldn't get it. See if we can get him to chase his curveball. There we go. Didn't chase it, but we got him out. So this is my last regular season stream for the Cardinals. This is our last season. It's our fifth season. We've won 100 games 3 years in a row, 90 the first year. Won the division 4 years in a row, trying for our fifth. And we lost in the World Series in 6 games to the Rangers last year. So this is our last season regardless. And I'll be starting a new one. And as I said before, it's either going to be the White Sox and try and rebuild them, move them to a new ballpark, that somebody else made, or move Oakland to Utah, making the Utah Avengers, put them in a new ballpark, and I will be making a whole lot of trades with both teams, but Oakland, I'm going to try and trade away as many of their guys as possible because we just played a whole franchise with them last year in Oakland, and I want to play with some of the, you know, a lot of the same guys, so we're going to do some trading. I'll keep Mason Miller and Rooker, but everybody else is going to be available for trade. And I'm contemplating the White Sox. We would just treat it like a normal franchise and play some games. The team's going to suck. But with Oakland, what I would probably do is I would sim the entire season and we would do the draft. And I'm seriously considering doing the whole first season in one stream. Just sim through spring training, get everything going, do our scouting, sim the games, not even play, just sim the games, do the scouting every week, do the draft, do the all-star, you know, home run derby if we have somebody, unload a bunch of salaries at the trade deadline, whatever salaries Oakland has, try to make as many moves as we can the first year, but not play, just sim, because I don't want to play in that ballpark, and then relocate them at the end of the season. And then when we go to the new ballpark, then we would start actually playing games. Track that down. There we go. So that's the game plan for those two options. And unless I change my mind between now and next March, I'm planning on doing a Giants franchise next year. Man, he just won't chase. Got him. Through eight. They're going to let me finish this game? Yes, they are. I'm only at 88 pitches. Let's see if we can throw a complete game shutout here. That's a rope. A little bit higher than you would have caught that. Six, four, three, double play. He's getting tired. I know he's getting tired. He's at 95 pitches. Strike one. See if he'll chase the slider. He's going to take the slider. Come on, high heat away. Got him. There we go. Here we go. We got to win 24. I think we got to go 24-4 to get to 100 wins. So that's going to be a tall task. We had such a rough August and part of June. But there we go. Painter. Trout with a home run. Four hits shutout. No walks. 10 strikeouts. Lost our perfect game with two out in the fifth. Two out in the fifth. Trout hit a home run and a steal. All right. Got them out of the way. Won five in a row. Swept Cincinnati on the road. Now we go home to play the Braves. And we lose 6-5. Austin Riley with a homer. Hence was eh. Miller was eh. All right. 81-59, so we'll easily finish 500. And we have a four-game lead over the Pirates. 81 wins. What is that? Yeah, best record in National League. And the National League has home field advantage in the World Series because they won the All-Star game. All right, Strider and Manoah. I don't feel like facing Strider. Lose 9-4. I will player lock next game. Gave up three home runs that game. Cano got beat up. Miller keeps getting beat up. Let's move you there. Look at that. Four of our five pitchers are hot. That's good. What about hitting? Royce is cold, huh? All right. Yeah, two guys with good chance for 100 RBIs. Gorman is close to 100 ribs. Winn. You know what? Let's flip Winn and Lewis, since Lewis is cold. In fact, let's play Sajacy and give him a break, and maybe that'll get him out of his cold streak. All right, so Hurston Waldrop. Let's go with Naylor. Their lineup is essentially the same, although they have Adley Rutschman. And if you watch Mr. Hurricane, the Braves signed Rutschman in there, too. He just wants to go play for the Braves, I guess. All right, they're down 3-0. Riley, three-run double. Yeah, right on the nose, but right at him. Now we're down 4-0. Yeah. We will not have anybody come close to 20 wins. Cease and Gallon. Win the World Series, sign Cease and Gallon. And they still have Strider, I assume. In this one, they have Strider. They have Strider, and they don't have much else. It's a weird one. Damn, 5-0. We had five games in a row, and now we're going to lose three in a row. Way out in front. Carried a lot farther than I expected. Yeah, Mason Winn with a two-run homer. Makes it close. Oh, that was a nasty slider. Derek signs. This has to be a computer player. We need to get on base so we can bring up the tying run. Because I believe it's Jordan Walker. Yep, Walker and Gorman are behind me, so I've got to find a way to get on base here. God damn it. Oh, it dropped. Wow, that was luck. Pure luck. All right, Jordan, three-run shot to tie this game. Let's go. 3-0 count. Ball four. Here comes Nolan Gorman with a chance for a walk-off grand slam. If he hits a walk-off grand slam, I'll do a double shot at tequila, guys. He's probably going to strike out. You guys owe me a double shot. Oh, this game. This game. He only gave up. He gave up two runs on one hit. Cutliff. His only hit that he allowed was the home run by Winn. All right. Just sim. Hey, we get a 5-3 win. Jared Jones. Bybee's 10-10 now. Somehow they got Jared Jones out of the Pirates. Okay. Three-game lead. Should be able to get over 90. Senga. I'll play against the ghost forkball. Let's see what happens. No, I didn't mean to sim it. God damn it. We lost. Gave up three home runs. Hit one home run. All right. Trevor McGill. I meant to hit play. This one always has okay, so I hit down and hit the button and hit simulate instead of play. All right. Let's play with Lars. Let's go Lars. All right, no score. One on, nobody out. This guy throws heat. Just kind of flipped that slider in there for strike one, but he's got 100 mile per hour gas. And I'm waiting for it, and I'm way out in front. He hasn't thrown it yet. Three sliders and a changeup. There it was, and we don't get it by the first baseman. Damn it. That's a shame. All right, Gorman with a two-run homer. Mason Winn with a solo homer. Puts Gorman at least 90 RBI. Winn's knocking on 90. We're going to have at least four guys with 90 ribs. Mason Winn with another two RBI. Yeah, Winn might have outside chance at 100. And he's out. Why are you trying to steal third with two outs? I think Walker and Naylor should get their 100 ribs for sure. Yep, it's just a lazy fly ball. And now they come all the way back and we're losing 8-5. Can you believe the sim? Did the guys at EA do the sim? You know, the college football where they come from behind, they're down 40 points in the fourth quarter, they come all the way back to beat you. And we lost. Six run, eighth inning. This team should be dominating. Should absolutely be dominating. Screw it. There we go. Sim to a 12-4 win. Cam and Arrow hit two home runs for the Mets. Logan, everybody got lit up on their staff. Newtbar and Winn with home runs. Mason Wynn's going to drive in 100 runs. All right. Winn, 95. Naylor, 95. Walker, 94. Gorman, 90. Trout only has 77 because he's mostly hitting leadoff, but he's got 33 home runs to lead the team. I wanted that power and speed at the top of the order because never fails. You'll get guys on at the bottom of the order and your leadoff guy comes in and he can't drive him in, right? Victor Scott, not doing too bad. Naylor and Gifo. Goodness sakes. 14 wins for Cutliff. Everybody else is around 10. 10 wins for Sandlin. Look at all the wins in our bullpen. Yeah, his ERA is almost 4. He's just been garbage lately. Shohei leads for the MVP. 122 RBI already. Jordan's in the American League. Look at that, Peter Vigna. That dude was in the very first draft. He went right before we could, we picked two picks after him. Cy Young and McClanahan. Lee Boyle went the pick right before us. We ended up with Cutliff. So that was a hell of a first round. I think Tharp went in that draft too, or the next one. Benson, Evan Carter, Classe, Will Vest. Benny Montgomery, Chase Petty, Graceffo, the 6 ERA. All right, let's save. 2.5 game lead. All right. Hey, Fromber facing our old guy. He's got 16 wins. Bybee and Ober, Painter. Yeah, let's pitch this Saturday game with Bybee. And we'll sim against Fromber and beat him 4-3. Mason Winn with 2 more RBI. Cutliff's got his 15th win. All right, we're going to play this game. Full game. Yep, that's our home alternate. They're going to wear those. Okay, we're good. Overcast. And let's see. Let's try and get Lewis hot again. All right, Contreras is not, no. No, he's regressing very rapidly, so. All right, so we have this game, and then we have a game against the Pirates the last week. And the rest are all going to be player locks or sims. Come on. It's a fucking game. I swear to God. It's one step. Field the ball and throw. And he like clanks it off his elbow. I mean, it was down, but that's not the location I was looking for. No. Game did not say he's going. I had no idea he was running. Scott's going to get this. All right. No harm, no foul. Bailey Ober. Let's go, Victor. Thank you very much. 99 speed dude. And he's going to go. He's slow to the plate. Easy steal. We'll give Trout a chance to drive him in from there. If he doesn't, we'll steal third. Oh, that's going to get him home, all right. That's back to the track. And that's going to be over the fence for a ground rule double, and he will score. It's his 30th double of the year. Come on, Josh. And that bad boy is foul. Couldn't see it in the overcast sky. Why would I swing at that? Late swing, right at the third baseman. Of course, he doesn't fumble it. Oh. Trout hurt his shin, diving head first back into second base. If he had been out for like the rest of the year, I would have restarted this. There's no way I'm going to lose him to a stupid fucking injury like that. All right. Unbelievable. He's only out a day or two. We'll just move Scott to center and put Donnie in left. Come on, Nolan. Wind's blowing out to right. And it's going to be right at him. Good contact, though. Man, my location is not anywhere close. I'm a Mason. It's a rope. There you go. Chase that shit in the dirt. Zach Veen is with the Twins. Okay. Got him. All right. Mason Winn knocking on the door. He's got 97 ribs. We have a chance to have four guys with 100 ribs. And that win 100 games because our pitching is so inconsistent. Both starting and relieving. Pete Alonso hit for the cycle. Of course he runs. Oh, it's over his head. Go, go, go. Shit, I thought he was going to catch it. He'd have been in third base if I was. I hit R2 because when you're running the bases on player lock, R2 makes you run forward. But when you're playing a full game like this, it's L1. Drives me insane. Come on, Lars. It's got to be the shoes. That's foul. Just missed. Nice pitch. We should track that down, but we're going to get to third base. All right. As long as we don't hit it to third or back to the pitcher, he should be able to score on this play. And this might be Royce's first series against his old team. Ooh, pulled off. Go. That's going to get a run home. All right, 2-0. There we go. Hank the Stank. Hank's got, looks like 19 home runs. Got a chance to have everybody with 20 home runs except for Donovan and Scott. Maybe Newtbar doesn't have it. I know that everybody in the middle of the order has more than 20. Yeah, under it. It's all right. Manufacturer run. There we go. It's a foul ball. Missed it. CPU never misses it. The hell? Four, six, three. There we go. What I was looking for. Foul. Got him. Late swing. All right. Gonna keep the bats going. Victor. You gonna do it again? That's what you do with a 99 speed dude, man. Lay that bunt down, steal second, maybe steal third. It's safe. That's down into the gap, just like we did with Trout. Trade spots. Bunt single, steal, double to the gap. Now if we can keep Donovan from getting hurt. All right, Josh. Ah, I thought that was a curveball and was going to drop down. I was going to get it up in the zone. Hit hard, deep. Not deep enough. If that was out to the warning track, I'd take off for third base, but Donovan's not a speed demon, so. All right, Jordan. Ah. Swinging that shit over my head. Carson, thanks for the follow. Welcome in. FG. How are you, my man? Trying to finish off this last regular season with the Cardinals. We had Trout injure his shin diving back into second base, so he's only out for a day or two. But we have a shot at having four guys with 100 RBI, man. But yeah, I'm trying to get this done. I have two more matches to ref tomorrow, two high school playoff matches, two semifinals. And then I'm done reffing. I had a college match about an hour and a half away yesterday over in Illinois. Yep. And, so I'm almost done with my fall season, which means you will see me a couple of programs in Diamond Dynasty. Nice. I have, I'm down to the last two, like the LCS and ALCS and NLCS programs. I've got everything else done, so I understand the grind, man. Godsmack, nothing more. Flat black, all right. Tell Godsmack hello for me. But FG, I'm going to stream at night a whole lot more frequently moving forward from today. Hey, do me a favor. You're on my Discord. About to get Mickey Mantle. Nice. Go to my Discord and go on the MLB The Show page, and there's a poll that I posted asking people which franchise they want me to do when I'm done with this one, which should be in the next week or so. The options are to move Oakland to Utah and make them the Utah Avengers. I've already got a color scheme and a logo and a ballpark and everything. Or take over the White Sox and try and rebuild them. And I downloaded a new ballpark from a guy who does really, really good ballparks. And we would move the White Sox to a new ballpark and try and rebuild them. So those are the two options. So I would like go over there and cast your vote. I've got a timer on there. I got it set for a week, so it has a few days left. I think it's 2-1 Utah to Chicago right now. But we will start that up as soon as we're done with this one and play that through the winter until the new game comes out. Carson, I was grinding the other day on Diamond Dynasty, playing at Coors on rookie, right? And I scored 63 runs on 75 hits and hit 35 home runs in 9 innings against the Rockies. let's see if this still works. See if that link works. Yeah, the most I had ever had was like 38 or something like that. And then I put up 56 and 63 in back-to-back games. You get all those 99 overall guys on your team. And I think I was doing the National League West team affinity. And I was loaded up with a bunch of guys from the National League West, and we just went ham. I think I posted the 53 one here. Look at this. There's 64 runs. There it is. Look at the top of the page as soon as it goes away. There we go. 64-1. Cal Raleigh went 11-for-11 with 7 home runs. So yeah, that was obnoxious. I think that game took me over an hour to play. Get through. There we go. Hold him up. All right, Victor, he's had 2 bunt singles, 2 stolen bases, 2 runs scored. And we pop it up. So now you know why we just bunt with him. Because he doesn't have a whole lot of pop in his bat. .551, yeah, I haven't hit one that far. I think something in the 530s is the longest I've ever hit. I've hit one like halfway up the scoreboard at Coors before with Acuna, but have not hit one 551. That's a tank. On All-Star. Ah. Throw the ball. Thank you. My God. He had to hold up because he wasn't sure I was going to catch it or not. So he ends up with almost a 400-foot single. Wow. I'll take that. That off of shoe tops. That sets this up. Got him. Of course it stays fair.
Count.
And we get another run home. All right, 3-2. All right, survive that little blip. Let's get some more runs, guys. Donovan's in because Trout got hurt running the bases. No ball, one strike. Ball one, up. And why is Trout on the Cardinals? Because I was playing my last season in this franchise, and I wanted to try and get a World Series for Trout because he's just buried with the Angels, so. We traded him Tommy Edman, Walker Buehler, and the number one prospect in baseball for Trout. Ah, late decision to swing. Should have let it go. It's ball anyway. Naylor and Walker are both like at 95 RBI. I think Winn's at like 97. Gorman is like around 90. We're trying to get four guys with 100 ribs. Nah. Way underneath and hooked it straight up in the air. All right, Jordan. See if you can find a gap here. Didn't drop enough. That's down in the corner. Boom. He's going to have to hold it first, but we'll get the guy all the way to third. If it doesn't hit the edge there and goes all the way into the corner, that's a double and probably score a run. All right, come on, Gorman. This is your chance, buddy. Nope, double play. God damn it. Bad luck hitting the side wall, or that's an RBI. Got him. Got him. Not getting there. All right, he's done. He's tired. We get him out. New pitcher for them. Fastball, curveball, slider, sinker. Go shoot that in there. Inching up towards 300. Come on, Newt. Off the end of the bat, very end of the bat. Good timing, bad contact. All right, Royce. Got a sack fly. Also has a hit. We can find green somewhere. There we go. There we go. Be patient. Can throw a strike. Just going to try and get a double play. Backed up on me. I'm lucky I missed it. I would have been jammed into a double play if I made contact with that. Who the hell's on first base? Winn. We're going to send him. I'm going to try and stay out of the double play. All right. That works. Throws it to the backstop. What, this game? I hate the way the CPU defense is completely different than the human defense. The CPU does shit that we can't do, and we can't even field simple ground balls sometimes. So, it's not balanced in that way. But the gameplay itself is head and shoulders better than, like, anything EA's ever put out. Send him. Stop at second. There we go. Royce, second hit, second RBI. Gap back to a two-run lead. Still nobody out. I'm sorry, one out. One out, not nobody. One out. Ooh, got the call. Yeah, the pitching. I have never given up more home runs than I have with this one. 23, I didn't give up nearly as many home runs as I do in this game. So the pitching is different. There's no margin for error. I'm pitching on legend, so there's like no margin for error. I've seen way too many low and away pitches pulled for home runs and up and in pitches yanked. There's no way they should get around. They should hit that to right field, and they just see way too many. I lost one game. I gave up four solo homers. But in general, yeah, it's a good game. I just like to rag on the game. That's going to drop. Yeah, I don't know. Two on, one out. Come on, Donnie, you're two for two. Three for three in this spot in the order. That's double play. Thought I was going to line that over the shortstop's head, but that's all right. Three-run lead. Bam. New pitcher. All right, righty and two lefties, so let's just go with Yuki. And their home runs are usually solo shots because I don't walk anybody. Painted. Thank you very much. Have a seat. There we go. 1, 2, 3. All right, boys. Get more runs. Ryan McGregor. It's got to be a computer-generated dude. That glove. That was a late decision. That was early. Late, early, late, early. Speed him up, slow him down. And we'll just golf that in there for a hit. Thank you. Walker's under 290, so we got to get him going. He's struggling. Come on. You know you want to throw it right down the middle. Oh, and I missed it. All right, Gorman, your average is just pitiful this year. Even when I play you. Even when I play lock on you. Just can't buy a hit with you. There we go. Just got to speak it into existence, right? Alright, 2-on-1 out. Mason, if you hit a 3-run homer, that gives you 100 RBIs, dude. Oh, way out in front. Stay back. Stay back. See it, baby. See it. Put this in the bullpen.
What did I just say? ribbies on the year.
Jerry, I'm telling you, I have this power, and I have no control over it.
All right, that's going on the thumbnail right there. I want to make sure I get the right one, so maybe we get it while he's swinging the bat. There we go. All right. Thumbnail taken care of. Come on, Lars. If you guys miss any of the episodes, just go to my YouTube. There's a whole Cardinals playlist and you can watch them. Usually up the night of or the next day after I do the stream. So it's my wonderful new fiber optic cable. Man, that shit's up immediately. Ah! That was a terrible swing. Texas is 8 games out. I need to see if they're going to be... Yeah, they're in the playoffs. We might have a rematch. Minnesota is going to be in the playoffs too, so we might face these guys if we can get to the World Series. Way out in front. Ball kept cutting in too. All right, let's sit in the middle of the plate. See if we can get this late. Keep it fair. Come on.
One, two.
Three for three. Three RBI against his old team. 432. 432 down the line. He's like, yeah. Thank you for trading me away. I appreciate it. I got paid and I'm on a good team. Bam. Left that slur right over the middle. Bam. All right. 17 hits. That deserves one of these, boys. Oh, it's not gonna be a full double shot. We're finishing off our bottle of Casamigos. There we go for the triple shot. I don't think we can get four. I don't think Victor has enough pop to get this out of the ballpark. I don't even know if he has enough power to get it to the gap over here by the welcome to the show sign on the wall to try and get it inside the park. He's only got 39 power, so that's why we always bunt with him. Speaking of that, he still almost beat it out, and that was a hard bunt. Three in a row. All right, Yuki, we'll leave you in for this guy because it's a lefty. That's foul. Got him. Ooh, he got that one. Is that going to stay fair? Yep. Hooked it right inside the foul pole. All right, let's get somebody else in here. Let's try and fix Mason Miller's ERA. Now pitching for the Cardinals, number 19, 10, Mason Miller. All right, now they're going back to back. Are we going to have Three in a row in back-to-back half innings. Well, let's not.
Ball. One ball, no strike.
Can you believe this shit? Three in a row for both sides. Home run derby, guys. Home run derby. My goodness. I can't even take him out because that's only the two batters, man. I told you, I've never given up this many home runs playing this game ever. It's like Catfish Hunter. He gives up, you know, 30 solo homers. Him or Blylevin, they always give up solo homers. Some of you guys might be too young, don't know who they are. Google them. And they're both Hall of Famers. I have to say, I'm glad I was alive during the best time of baseball. The late 60s, 70s, and 80s. Once the Yankees started winning a bunch of World Series in the 90s, it kind of sucked again. But you got to see the best pro sports. I get to see Wilt Chamberlain, Dr. J, Michael Jordan, Magic and Larry. A ton of Major League Baseball Hall of Famers. Wow, what a shit show for those six outs. Take the 44, good. Hey, FG, my fantasy football league. I'm one game out of first. I'm only 4-3, but I've scored the most points in the league. And I've given up the third most. One of the guys in first place has given up 240 less points than I have in seven games. Is that another home run? No, it's off the wall. And I've scored over 150 more, almost 150 more points than him. It's just not fair. But my team is finally getting healthy. I need Tua to be back and be himself because I have Achan. And I also have Waddle, and I really need Waddle. I need Waddle to be himself. And listen to this wide receiver room. When I get Nico Collins back, I'll have A.J. Brown, Nico Collins, T. Higgins, Wandale, and Waddle. And my backs are Gibbs and Achan. My tight end is Kittle. My quarterbacks are Geno, Anthony Richardson, and I picked up Drake May and got that 20-point game. He's got a couple, two or three rough games coming up, but then he's got a stretch of a bunch of really good matchups. So I'm in really good shape. Yeah, we don't. Our league is an auction, so we don't have draft picks to trade. We have $150 to spend on 17 players. And all the top wide receivers, like the top five guys, all went for over $40. Can you believe that? $40 for a fucking wide receiver. I got A.J. Brown. He was the cheapest of the whole group. I got him for $32. And I kept Jahmyr Gibbs for $27. And I had Achan for $5. And I kept Anthony Richardson for $4, but I'm about ready to cut his ass. Somebody just cut Herbert today. Might get him to third base. Nope. Not deep enough. It's up against the wall, I would send him. But I've been running this league since 1998, and we still have half the original people playing in the league. And first place is $850. Come my way in June? Hey, just let me know, man. I bought tickets for a Cardinals-Giants game, and 49er couldn't make it. Went to that game and saw a good game. So let me know. Get tickets. Go see the Cardinals. Need a place to crash. You got an extra bedroom upstairs, an extra bedroom downstairs. Jays are in town. That's fine. I like the Blue Jays. I love the Blue Jays in the 80s, man. Jesse Barfield, Lloyd Mosby, Tony Fernandez, Dave Steeb, all those dudes. They were fucking fire. Tom Hickey. Let's get this guy out of the game. All right, we'll bring in JoJo. I took my son to Kansas City, 7 or 8 years ago. Whenever Stroman was on the Blue Jays last, we drove to Kansas City and went and watched the Royals play the Blue Jays. I also took a trip, get this, it was whatever year Toronto had the All-Star game, like 1990 or something like that, 90, 91. My best man and I drove from St. Louis to Toronto. Left at midnight, got there at 4:30 or so in the afternoon, and watched the Blue Jays play the Mariners. It was Tom Candiotti's first game with the Blue Jays. Got to see Ken Griffey. And after the game was over, we drove back to Detroit, slept for a few hours, and then went to Tiger Stadium and saw the Indians and the Tigers play. Tom Selleck was there. He didn't have his mustache, but he was decked out in a Tigers uniform taking batting practice. It was right when he was making Mr. Baseball. And after that game was over, we drove to Bowling Green, had dinner, then drove to Cincinnati, spent the night across the river in Kentucky. And then that Sunday, we went to Riverfront and saw the Astros and Reds. And then we drove home. And we were coming through East St. Louis around midnight with a bunch of money in our pockets. So we stopped at strip bar over there and blew the rest of her money and got home at 4:30. So, yeah. We were originally just going to go to Chicago, but both the White Sox and the Cubs were out of town. So, like, fuck it. We can just go a little bit further east and go to Toronto. Skydome is like a big, huge mall. It's like got all this. Why did he miss the ball? They got all this neon lights and shit on the concourse. Looks like you're in a mall. He put his glove up and just ran right by the ball. We're in a safe situation now. There we go.
And that's a winner! That's a winner!
Well, we saw something new in that game. Three home runs in a row by me. Next half inning, three home runs in a row by the CPU. Oh, man. St. Louis, Kansas City, Omaha. Yeah. Jimmy in Iowa, Wrigley, nice. I've been to the new Cincinnati Stadium. I saw him play the Brewers there. My son had a baseball tournament, week-long baseball tournament in Cincinnati. Got to play at Xavier University and stuff, and we went and saw the Brewers. They absolutely lit up the Reds. It was like 10-3 in the second inning, so we just started walking around the stadium. There we go, Lewis, 22nd home run. Winn, 24th. Davis, his 20th. Mason Winn, 3 RBI, gets him to 100 on the season. And Trout left early. Should only be out a day or two. All right. 1 to 6 days. 1 to 6 days. Where do we change that? All right. And we lose 7-2. 3 home runs allowed. Joe Ryan. Gorman hits a home run. All right. 85-64. We only have a 2-game lead. 2-game lead, and the Pirates are the second best team in the National League. Reds are eliminated. Cubs are about to be. 91 wins for the Guardians, 88 for the Astros, 85 for the Orioles. Again, National League has home field advantage in the World Series. So, all right, at the Chubbs, let's player lock. Oh, what else do? Royce Lewis is playing center field, really? Why wouldn't Victor Scott play center field? All right, we'll play as Jordan Walker. Oh, so yeah, FG, we'll be doing a lot of nighttime streams moving forward. It's easier for me to stream after the wife goes to bed than do it during the day when she's up. Because she don't give one fuck about being quiet. She's a short, feisty redhead. She doesn't give one shit about what I'm doing. Yeah, she's 5'1 and acts like she's 6'3. Subtight spot. Here we go. Yeah, she's feisty, all right. Dude, we just hit 3 home runs in a row. And then the very next half inning, the computer hit 3 home runs in a row. We are trying to lock down this division. And Mason Winn just hit a 3-run homer to get his 100th RBI. And we have Walker and Naylor that are close to getting 100. And Gorman has a very slim chance. He's sitting around 92 or something like that, so he's got work to do. Nice pitch. Oh, if you guys are on my Discord and have not voted, go vote in the poll for which team you want me to do next. It's either going to be Oakland and we move them to Utah, rename them, put them in a new stadium, and totally start trading the shit out of that team. Or we take over the White Sox, put them in a new ballpark, stay in Chicago, and try to fix them. Of course he hits it to the deepest part of the park. All right, bases are loaded, nobody out. We got to get this ball out of the infield. That'll get the run home. There we go. RBI, everybody. Second and third move up. Give us the lead. Somebody else knock in some more. There we go. Scott and Naylor with RBI. 4-1 lead, one out. New pitcher. Come on, Jay Walk. I really wish the college football game wasn't complete ass. I want to play football, but I'm not reinstalling that game. Not even the fuck around. Scott with a two-run homer. He has 30-something power. Hammered it into the ground. Beat it out, so inning keeps going. Gorman 2-for-4. He's probably going to strike out since he has a 2-strike count. Oh, he flipped it in there and gets 3 hits. Hey, might get him over 250 before the end of the year. Only one down. Yeah, there we go. Come on, Mason. 1-for-4. Can you go deep, please? There's no way he's going to get a double play. There we go. Men at the corners and two out. Come on, Lars. Find a gap. Here we go. In the corner. It's going to score at least one. Around second. Digging for third. Sending him around third. Play at the plate. And it's safe. Oh, he did the little fake tag. Reach around. Got the reach around tag. 9-2. Here we go. Cubs are gone. 4 hits for Victor Scott. 2 doubles and a homer. Jordan's got 95. Naylor's got 97. Good start by Tink. Like that. 7 runs in the last 3 innings. Finish the game strong. All right, 86 and 64, 2-game lead. Here's our RBI. Naylor needs 3, 5, 9. Trout needs to get back. All right, Freddie Peralta. We'll just sim that game. And we win 3-1. Victor Scott with another home. He loves Wrigley Field. My goodness. Wow. Wow. My goodness. All right, Todd against Chris Cutliff. Ooh. We got hammered. 12 runs. Victor Scott hit another home run. Whoa. What the hell? All right, Naylor's at 99, he's at 96. Victor Scott with 4 home runs, and I think he's hit at least 3 of them this series. He's got 39 power. This game sometimes makes no sense whatsoever. None. And we only have a 1-game lead. And look what's coming up next week. What do we have time-wise? 2 hours. All right, so we'll just sim this game. And we lose 5-0. Bybee got lit up. We have a tie, folks. We have a tie. We have 9 games left in the season, and we are tied with Pittsburgh. I do not want to play a wild card round. We have got to get our shit together. All right. Mike Trout. We finished off that Casamigos, but I have this brand new bottle. Reposado Oro de Lidia. Can't see it. It's 80 proof, 40% alcohol. Not bad. Not overly strong. We'll see how that does with shots. Come on, Mikey. Oh, tried to jump on that high curveball. There we go. Look how red that heat zone is. Jesus. 3-1. Yeah. Full count. Come on. You know you want to throw it over the middle of the plate. Let's go. Oh, too early. Goddamn changeup. Throw me that slow-ass fastball you got. There we go, that's through. Hey, Mason Winn with a home run. Tie game. I gotta stay back and wait. This guy does not throw hard. Bases loaded walk gives us the lead. Oh, jammed me. Get out of play. Through. There we go. Little one out rally. A little hit and run there. Trying to stay out of the double play. There we go, there we go. Way to swing the bat, Josh. Man at the corners and only one out. See if we can get this ball out of the infield. Come on, Nolan. You're due, man. You're way due. Put one over the wall. It's too shallow. I can't run. Way too shallow. Takes a hit. Come on, Jaywalk. You're knocking on the door for 100 ribs, too. Three-run homer would take care of it, I think. Flip. Nope. 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 All right. Ah, now we're down 3-2 in the ninth. One on, nobody out. We gotta quit losing these games, man. We're giving up shit late. Oh, Naylor with a two-run shot, and we win. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. I think that puts him over 100. Wow. Four hits for Josh Naylor. Yep. Gets him to 101. Mason Winn with 101. Thank you. About time we actually win something in the sim. And not the fast sim, just in-game sim. That was a huge win. 88-66. We're still tied. Who the hell is Pittsburgh playing? Oh, well, of course. They're playing Colorado. And then they got to play Philadelphia. So, Colorado, then us. We have Tampa Bay and Pittsburgh. So, all right. We'll just straight sim this one. And we win 5-3. There we go. Nootbaar, Trout, and Lewis with two. Tink pitched well. Bullpen. JoJo was but he got the win. And we have a one-game lead over Pittsburgh. All right. Are we going to have a one-game lead, a two-game lead, or a tie heading into this series with Pittsburgh? Manoah and Misurowski. Ooh, let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Gonna go Gorman. I got to get this guy going. All right. Bases are loaded with one out in the first. All right. We cannot strike out or hit into a double play. Put the ball in the outfield. Oh, son of a... Where that? Fuck. Wasted chance. We don't score. Bases loaded. Nobody out. We don't score. Now we got two outs, so I have to get a hit. Fuck me. Right, Adam. Of course. Of course. Still no score. First time with nobody on base. And last year, it was like automatic. I was going to get a home run when I player locked with him. And this year, just can't do it. Is that going to get out? Is that going to sneak over? No, it's not. Up against the wall, you redneck mother. Still no score. Seventh inning, two on, one out. Look at this shadow. Get through. There we go. Down the line. RBI double. Yes, yes, yes. Just inside the bag. Booyah. Come on, Mason. Get the ball out of the infield. Get us another run. Man, you've been clutch all fucking year. Ball four, bases loaded. Lars, two for two, bases loaded, one out. Got to get this ball out of the infield. Squeeze play, and they're going to throw to first. Wow. He had plenty of time to go home. Wow. Brain cramp by the pitcher. He had plenty of time to go to the plate. My goodness. All right, so JC, let's go. Nope. Hey. 2-0. Manufactured 2 runs. We have 13 hits, but only 2 runs. Bases loaded again. Didn't get it. Please, hold on. Get this dub. Yes. 2-1. 2-1. 3 hits for Trout. Manoa. Duran, 39 saves. All right. That was a little tense. All those hits, all those base runners, and only got 2 runs. Redbirds didn't make the AAA, didn't make the postseason. Double A won their division, so they're going to go on to the playoffs. Look at that guy. 164 and 192, 263 ERA, 14 and 6, not bad. C potential. This guy's an A potential, 216 ERA, 14 and 6. Got a closer with a 104 ERA. Got 2 dice Ks. Look at this double A team. Cabrera, this guy's a guy we drafted. 28 steals, hitting 340. Doesn't have power, but my God, he's like kind of like Rod Carew type player, right? Crespo, we drafted him. Chase Davis. Crooks is on the DL. All right. All right. And we do have a 1-game lead. We have both clinched playoff spots. We are easily the best team in the National League. All right. Where is our RBI at? We need 4 for Walker and 8 for Gorman. Man, last year, Gorman had 50 home runs and 131 ribs. He's just fallen off. Walker, 34 and 1 season. We just, as good of a season as we've had, we're actually worse than last year. Mason, career high in home runs, career high in hits, doubles, home runs, RBIs, batting average, runs. No, he had 85 back here. Good Trout. He's regressing, but not badly. Royce's average is terrible. It, almost 100 points lower than last year. That's just, fuck, 60 less hits. Cutliff's going to get 200 innings. Oops. Yeah, Cutliff's definitely going to get 200 innings. No one else will. All right, guys. We've already pitched with him and him. So we are going to pitch this game with Cutliff. We win this game, we will be no worse than tied going into the last 3 days. And If we are tied on the last day of the season, I will play that whole game. I won't player lock anybody. We'll play that whole game at Tampa Bay. And that'll be Cutliff again. So, if we need that game, I will play that game. So, here we go. Some reason we rested Lewis instead of him playing Sajacy, but that's okay. That's right. We'll give him a day off. Here's Cutliff. This is essentially a playoff game right here. I mean, we're both in the playoffs, but this is to not play the first round. And they have Soto and Alonso. Got him. Got him out in front. There we go. Trout runs over. No damage. All right. No damage. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Hit me with the pitch, asshole.
Got it.
All right, Mikey. That enough? Nope. Shy of the warning track. On the warning track. Just got under it. Wind is blowing out to left, so shoot it that way. Get a little extra carry. Gotta like that.
Off the plate, ball one. Well, that's off the plate, ball two.
Come on. All right. Survived two leadoff walks. I don't know why I'm walking, guys, now. And pitched those two batters any differently than I normally do. And it's line drive right at them. Everything is right at them. Oh, home run distance, but ow. Just missed the line. Right, let's sit more in the middle of the plate now. Bat, light that off. Just can't stay back, even on 96. About ate me up. All right, fine. I'll sit on the inner half. That's where you're going to throw the ball. I did not swing. That was a check.
1-0.
Come on. There we go. First hit of the game. Almost took his head off. Holy shit, that just missed him. All right, so JC, your turn. Ah, flinched. I like that. One pitch out. Thank you. There we go. Nice quick inning. 1-2-3. Let's fucking go. Come on, Henry. Hank the Stank against your old team.
Inside, ball one.
This pitcher used to play for the Cardinals, too. Jammed. Ball backed up on me. Oh, and he threw him wild. Pulls him off the bag. A rare error by the CPU. Yeah, it's going to be a line drive right at him. It's all right. Here goes their first hit of the game. Oh, come on. Motherfuck! Sit the fuck down. Oh, of course. Inside the bag. Gonna score a run. Damn it. What's up, Batten? How you doing, man? We have a one-game lead over Pittsburgh for first place with six games left. We have a three-game series here, and we have a one-game lead. And then we go to Tampa Bay to end the year, and they play, I think, at home against Philly. We are the two best teams in the National League, so we'll get home field all the way through, or we'll have to fight through a wild card. There we go, Nolan!
Oh, yeah!
Hit that right out where my daughter and I usually sit when we go to the game, right beyond the bullpen in front of that scoreboard. Hey, Batten, Mason Wynn's got 100 ribs on the season, man. Take that, Mr. Hurricane. Come on.
Three balls, one strike.
Who's on deck? It's the JC. There we go. They signed Soto and Alonso 2 years ago. This is like their second or third year with Pirates, so we have not hit as many home runs this year as we did in the past, and our pitching is like up and down. We'll pitch great, and then we'll pitch like shit. And the starting will struggle, but relief does great. Starting pitches great, the bullpen struggles. It's just very inconsistent pitching when I'm not pitching. Get in there. And I've given up way too many home runs when I'm pitching. And I normally don't do that. All right, Hank, let's go. Fuck you and your sinker. Always just inside the bag. Never right to my guy. Unbelievable. It's like the third or fourth time tonight. Yeah, they can still win the division. Hey, Batten, are you on my Discord? I have a poll over there right now. It's either going to be the White Sox, and we rebuild them and move them to a new ballpark, or we move Oakland to Utah, change their name to the Utah Avengers, new colors and everything, new ballpark, and I trade almost everybody away and try and just rebuild that team as quick as I can, but not have the same amount of the same guys that we had with the Oakland one last year. So this is my last... Is it? Okay. This is my last regular season stream for the Cardinals. Just be playoffs and then we're done. If it's tied, then I will break the tie. And I already know how I will vote. Spell. This is where they run the pitch count up unnecessarily. Oh, there's five votes now, so it's not tied. And I have not voted. I'm saving my vote in case there's a tie. Stay back. Yeah, somebody voted. It's got five votes now, so. God, can we work a walk here? Is that possible? Of course he tracks it down. So tired of the gold glove defense in this game by the CPU. It's just maddening. Trout says, fuck you and your foul ball catch. That was a rocket fucking piss missile, man. Do you see how low that was? Ah, what am I doing? Swinging at that garbage inside my ankles. Come on, jaywalk. Oh. Oh yeah, I hate the new college game. I uninstalled it after 3 weeks. It was barely September and I'm done. Just battling. Helpful. Work that count. Let's go. Ooh, that was ball four, and I swung at it. Thank God I fouled it off. Right down the pipe. Good timing, and it's a weak sister pop-up. Yeah, I warned you guys about that game. The gameplay is all that matters. None of the other garbage. The gameplay is ass. It's just garbage. Gameplay. I don't care about anything else. The recruiting didn't bother me at all. It's just, the sim is broken, for one. And I can't complete any passes downfield. I got to throw nothing but shallow crossers and drags and mesh and everything like that. Otherwise, it gets picked. Dude, I played against FCS and threw five fucking picks, including back-to-back pick sixes. I barely won the game against FCS, and I'm like, this is, fuck this game. I don't even like it on the Heisman is impossible because the game cheats too bad, and the next one down, All-American, is not much better. So yeah, I'm a much happier person by not having to deal with that bullshit. Oh, why do they always seem to find the holes? Why can't they just hit the ball at somebody for a change? This is his last inning. Yeah, I didn't even bother with either one of those two. My son likes to play in NHL. He can play that all he wants. There we go. All right. He's done. He is tired. He's going to be tired. New pitcher, Quinn Priester. Sinker, slider, fastball, curveball, change. Got fucking kitchen sink, man. All right, Gorman's got one tank shot. Let's see if we can get two. Three. that shit up. Like that. Is that got enough? Is that going to be off the wall? It's off the wall. There we go. There we go. There we go. Hammered that. Come on, Mason. He's going to try and get me to ground the ball to the left side of the infield. So I'm going to try to be late on purpose and drive this to the right side so that we can get the runner over. Look inside, swing late, hit it to the right side, move him up. Yeah, we don't want to swing at that pitch. We want it more over the plate. Like that. There we go. Move him up. Smart baseball. Now we got to get the ball out of the infield. Come on, Newt. That'll get him home. Doesn't have a lot of speed, but he should beat it. Yep, bad throw. Tie game, boys. Tie game. All right, it's JC. Can you get on base? Battle, battle, battle. Let's go. Let's go. Thumb. Fell off the left. Fell off this left. He's up to 13 pitches. That's good. 14 pitches. Going to throw 15. Still got a ton of energy. Must be a starting pitcher. All right. Battled back. Three straight innings with one run. 97 pitches. I'll let him face the lefty. Ball one. Now he comes out. I don't know why he didn't step on the bag and then throw it, but that's all right. We got the lead runner out. One and two. There we go. Pitching and defense, boys. Pitching and defense. All right, Henry. Damn. We only have a one game lead on a division. We need this game, guys. Desperately need this game. All right, we're going to steal the third. Now we gotta get the ball through the infield. Just like that. Can you tell I was alive for Whitey Ball back in the 80s with the Cardinals? Get on, steal your way around, move the runner up, knock him in. Yeah. You don't need to hit three-run homers all the time. I do like three-run homers, but I also like stolen bases. I grew up in the era of Lou Brock, Tim Raines, Ricky Henderson, all those boys. Nolan, he's on deck. There we go. Game's getting out of control on the Pittsburgh side. Only one out. Gorman's got a double and a homer. Ooh. Stay back. Stay back. Let that ball travel. All right, he doesn't have good wheels, so a single will get him home. Come on, Mason. Let's go, buddy. Come on, Mason. Newt's on deck. So far out in front. Missed it. Hit under it. I don't think that's going to carry. Hey, we have the lead. Oh, come on. One and one. Wow. Totally missed my spot. Got him. Got through Soto and Alonso. There it is. There we go. Three outs to go. Let's go. Let's go. I used to sit in that club, those seats right there, right above the show 24 sign. Come on, Lars. I don't care about a save. I want the win. Two strike out and he hits him. Uh-oh. We don't have to worry about a double play if that ball's out of here. To the track, to the wall. Gone! Golf that thing. Bam. To the David Freeze Berman center field. There we go. I like a 4-run lead much better than a 2-run lead. That's going to not get shy. Not even to the warning track. Barely to the arch in the grass. All right. One down. Victor. We're just going to swing away with Victor. Ooh, swing over that changeup. There we go. There we go. You know what's up next? You know what's better than a 4-run lead? 5-run lead. Safe. It's okay. You walk him, I'm going to steal with both of them.
Full four, take your base. Now pitching for the high hole. Number 57, Bubba Chandler.
It's going. Ooh, what a throw. Still got a guy in scoring position, but that was a ridiculous throw right on the bag. Just cost, didn't cost us a run because that would have been a double play. That's right. Down. This is to give us a 2-game lead with 5 games to play. These guys have stuck around since early June and just haven't let us get too far ahead. Been able to fight them off. There we go. Ooh. They give us that call, but they didn't give us the one earlier, which led to three runs. Fellas, two-game lead. Two more games to play against these jokers. Everybody at Walker had a hit. Trout's got 35 home runs now. Gorman's got 93 ribs. Cutliff does not get the win, but our bullpen three no hit innings. All right. This is a lot more challenging than any of the other seasons we've had. We've pretty easily won the division in all the other years. All right, Bybee and Liberatore. We're at 3 hours. Might have to play another full game if we get to the end of the season and last day. All right, we're just going to go straight sim on this one. And we win 5-1. Solo homer by Sawinski. Naylor, Walker, and Donovan with home runs. Bybee's got his 12th win. We're up to 92 wins. We have a 3-game lead. With 4 games to play. Three-game lead, 4 games to play. Mitch Keller and Andrew Painter. We'll player lock on this one. Hold on, I need to fix my lineup. And who do we want to play a lot? Let's do Naylor. All right, boys, this would clinch the division if we win this game because we're up 3 with 4 to play. And we're down 3-0 already. That ball was going to shoot by him. Come on, Jordan. Come on, Jordan. That's not going to work. And Newt Barr with a 3-run homer gets us back in the game, and we got 2 on, 2 out. Second inning, slugfest. Is it gonna drop? Nope. 6-3. We just can't stop giving up runs. I don't know if that's got enough juice. And with a double to lead off the inning. Good, good, good. Tying runs on deck. Come on, Jordan. Do something, man. Just over the wall. Yep. Move the runner up. All right. It's fine. Now we got to get the ball out of the infield. preferably a hit, not a fly ball, because I do not have speed. Come on, Nolan. Park this bitch. Let's go. Well, that'll get a run home. All right, two-run game here in the fifth. Still a two-run game in the seventh. Nootbaar with another home run. Oh, man. Down three. Nobody on. Two outs in the ninth. Buck and hockey goalie. All right, it's two-game lead with three to play. Key Brian Hayes had four hits. Newt's up to 20 home runs. Gorman's got 94 ribs. Painter, fuck. Nobody could stop their offense that game. All right. Tampa Bay series. Hopefully we won't have to, but if I have to, I'll play the last game with Cutliff. Two-game lead. Walker needs three. Gorman needs six. Trout's got 100 runs, 80 RBIs. That's what we brought him in for. Tink needs one more K for 200. Manoa's already over 200. Look at all these strikeouts. My goodness. These bullpen ERAs are just killing me. Mason Miller with 100 innings in relief. Let's do this. All right. They have Philly. So what we're going to do is we're going to sim that game. And the Phillies lose. Pittsburgh wins 3-0. All right. So two-game lead is down to a game and a half. We lost. We have a one-game lead with two to go. Walker hit a home run. Fuck. 18 innings. 18 innings, man. Just blew through the bullpen. Damn. And the Pirates win. Skeens beats Skubal. Half game out. And we're going to face McClanahan. All right, we'll player lock. We need to check our season series before we go to the last game. Safe. Who stole? There's Trout with a steal. All right.
Two strikes.
jammed me. Couldn't get around on that thing. All right, no score. Still no score in the fourth. Get through. And we're down 3-1 because of Rosarena hit a three-run homer. All right. Bring up the tying run. Come on, Mason. Come on, Mason. We gotta walk him and get to Gordon. Gorman. Not Gordon. Gorman. Yep. He walked him, so now 2-1. No, it's Brendan. Why's Donovan playing against a lefty? Moved him up. Base hit ties the game. Come on, Royce. We put you back in the lineup. You love to hit lefties. Is that going to make it out of here? Booyah! Three-run bomb. Yes. 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 Earbud died right in the middle of that play. There we go. That's why we put you back in. You crush lefties. Boom. Love McClanahan, but there we go. All right, 2-1, 1 out. We need this run. Damn thumb slipped off the joystick. It's twice it's done that tonight. Out in front of it. There we go. Bases loaded. Only one out. Perfectly placed. Come on, Mason. We need this right now. In the gap. Let's go. That's going to get a run home. Yep, yep, yep. 5-3. Base hit scores two more. Come on, Donnie. Oh, what a play. What a play. All right. Battled back. Got the lead. And gave up a solo homer, so it's only a one-run lead. This guy's thrown 44 pitches. You don't have anybody else in the bullpen? That was a big fat meatball. Look at that. Right down the damn middle. And I was 3 days in front of it. Not that time, but he snagged it, of course. Because we hit everything. We either hit a home run or we hit it right at him. We got the win. So we have a one game lead with one game to go. Manoah, 12-12. 40th save for Duran. Fucking drama I did not want. I wanted this over. If we could have just beat Pittsburgh that third game, this would be easy. There it is. One game lead. All right, now let's look at the calendar and see what we've done against the Pirates. Because if we have the tiebreaker, then it doesn't matter. All right, we beat them 3 out of 4 there. So 5-2. 7-3. Nine and four. So we've won the season series. So we have basically clinched the division, because on the tiebreaker, the Pirates become the wild card. Look at that. We've only lost 17 games in division. Wow. They've scored more runs than us, too. All right, so I'm just going to play lock with the pitcher on this game. I'm not going to bat. All right, Chris. All right, Walker with an RBI double. Pop fly, go get that, get that, get that. Thank you. One down. Freddie Freeman's on Tampa Bay. Really? When the hell did that happen? How does he reach an outside slider and hook it to right? That changeup was in a bad spot. Almost got the force play. Wow. Way more eventful than I wanted. God damn, how many foul balls are you gonna hit here? Swing at that, motherfucker.
You love.
All right. We didn't sim the Pirates game, so they should show up on the crawl down on the bottom. And we're up 1-0 still. All right, scoreless game in a first for that one. Just went with it. Fuck. Refresh, guys. The first baseman, number five, Freddie Freeman. Come on. Got him. Tie game because I didn't hustle. I made that a lot worse than it should have been. Hey, Lewis with a two-run homer. Way to go, Royce. This guy, 19 fucking foul balls, man. Look at this dude. Sit your ass down.
Out. That's a foul ball.
There we go. All right. Through four. Keep those sticks moving. There we go. 5-1. What we need. He's got me twice by going the other way. Lucky that stayed in the park. So many goddamn foul balls. Fuck. Always just out of our reach. Come on. And this motherfucker is going to foul off 18 more bats. There we go. At least he didn't hit 19 foul balls. Get some more runs back since I gave those up. New pitcher. We lost. We fucking lost. Four runs in the ninth. Fucking Duran, man. So we won because, like I said, we beat them head-to-head, but they get to take on Philadelphia, who they just played, and the winner of that plays us. So Miami's going to take on either the Dodgers or Milwaukee, and we've got to take on possibly the Pirates in the first round. Okay. Cleveland gets either Houston or Seattle, and Baltimore either gets the Yankees or Minnesota. Tink Hentz led the league in winning percentage. Josh Naylor led in batting average. Look at Brandon Marsh. My goodness. Mason Winn, third in doubles. This is a drafted player. Home runs by Alonso. 35 by Sawinski. 34 by Soto. 30 by Cruz. Jesus Christ. We had 35 by Trout. 31 by Gorman. 28 by Naylor. 27 by Lewis. 27 by Walker. Stone Garrett, really? Stone Garrett. Back-to-back 100 RBI years in his 30s. Wow. Bo Bichette's on the Marlins. This guy was in the first draft. Second draft. Acuna with 44 steals. D.L. Hall had 18 wins for the Brewers. Wow. 18-7. No 20-game winners. And we traded Valdez off to get Royce Lewis. Tink Hentz was 12-4 with 206 strikeouts and 180 innings. Cutliff was 15-6 after going 13-7 his rookie year. His home runs and walks are killing me, man. Yeah, this guy, 4 ERA. With those numbers. Manoah, 3 shutouts. This is the guy that we didn't get the first year. Look at all those strikeouts. My goodness. 800 strikeouts in 748 innings. God, man. Look at Brandon Marsh. My goodness. 46 doubles, 30 homers, 98 walks, 333. Josh Naylor won the batting title. Shohei won the MVP. Yordan in the other league. Gilbert was Cy Young. McClanahan. Batting title, Brandon Marsh. Reliever of the year. Rookie of the Year, Ben Montgomery. Should have been Sean Mora. Chase Petty's okay. Graceffa was terrible. Gold Glove. Do we get any Gold Gloves? Naylor. Royce just missed. Mason Winn just missed. Gorman got a Silver Slugger, really? The only one. All right. There's Mike Trout's only season with the Cardinals. 295, 3580 with 12, scored 100 runs, spent most of the year batting leadoff. Jordan Walker just missed 100 RBIs. Winn and Naylor. Look at all this. Look at the Pirates. Reynolds is hurt. He's out for the year. It's not going to show it on here. So we won 93 games. So we won 90, 101, 102, 193. Won the division 5 straight years. We made 1 World Series trip and lost in 6. So, all right, that's going to do it for the regular season. That was our last regular season stream for the Cardinals. So, what is today? So tomorrow I have to ref 2 high school playoff matches. And my grandson, who just turned 1 earlier this week, we're having a party for him Saturday night. In fact, the party will start before Alabama-Mizzou is over, so hopefully it's a blowout one way or the other. Otherwise, I'll miss the end of the game. So I would say, you know what? Let's advance and see who we're going to play first. Ooh, Pirates lost to the Phillies. Scooble gets the win. Skeens gives up 4. The Cardinals won the Texas League Championship, the AA Cardinals. 3-2 win by Pittsburgh. Oh, man, Albies is on the fucking Phillies. I forgot that. All right, here it is. And we're going to take on the fucking Phillies. Yeah, yes, yes. No more Pirates. They got upset. In the 9th inning. The 9th inning. They scored in the 9th. They beat the closer. There it is. We're taking on Philadelphia. Dodgers beat Milwaukee in 2. Houston beat Seattle in 2. Minnesota beats the Yankees in 3. So Baltimore, Minnesota, Houston, and Cleveland. We have not played any of those teams in a World Series in this franchise. We played Cleveland when we were with the Rockies. So, Miami and LA, Cardinals and Phillies. All right, so let's take a look at the Phillies. Scooble, Urquidy, Sandoval, Aaron Nola, Mick Abel. So they have good pitching. Bullpen is okay. I think that's their closer. Yeah. He only has 57 clutch. So their bullpen is not as good as their starting pitchers at all. Kirk is their catcher. Bryce Harper at first, hit 25. He's regressing. So he's not your dad's Bryce Harper. Albies always gives me trouble, but he had an off year. He had a really off year. Okay. Aiden Miller, one of their prospects. He's only hitting 230. He's got a little bit of pop. Trey Turner at short, and he's regressing. Look at that. He's still getting 27 mil a year going forward, and he is regressing. Oof. Okay. Olivares hit 24 home runs. We drafted that guy and traded it to him. Rojas, good contact, good speed, no power. And I don't know who Gabriel Rincones Jr. is. Got any injuries? This guy's injured. Wow. They were only a 500 team. So a 500 team knocked off a 93 win team in the first round. So Marlins and Dodgers. Yeah, this is going to be. This is going to be in our favor. This is good, good, good. They have good pitching. Good closer. Two good closers. The rest of their bullpen's not great. Ooh, Ethan Salas. Pardon me. Ethan Salas in Mejia. Mountcastle. Lee Castro. This is a rookie. Bo Bichette. Schneider and Bowers and Cutler. That was a draft pick. Hurstead's in the minors. Oh. Why is he in the minor leagues? Okay. Maybe he'll be up for this round. The Doyers. They still got Mookie Betts playing short. Nothing in right. Outman's pretty good. Schwarber. Got power, no contact. Betts and Sweeney. Bohm and Candelario. Nico Horner. Yandy. Yeah, we definitely need Miami to win. Yeah, look at that fucking staff. They got 80s in their bullpen. That it should be starting. So, yeah, we're rooting for Miami. Rooting for Miami. All right. Our path to the World Series just got a lot easier. So, all right, boys and girls, we are done. We are done. Anybody out there we can go raid? I don't think so. You got anybody you want me to go raid? Otherwise, I'm going to let you guys go. It's after midnight. I don't see anybody. What do I have on the raid side over here? Yeah, I don't see anything. There's a dude playing his Astros year two, the Hajj Mahal. He's got no viewers. You want to give this guy some viewers? Let's go give this guy some viewers. I don't know him. All right, let's go help this guy out. I'll start this raid. You guys are ready? Head on over there. I might be back Saturday night. Otherwise, maybe Sunday. I'll try to get the first round of the playoffs in this weekend. Otherwise, we'll definitely be streaming at night next week. So you guys have a good rest of the night. Good rest of the weekend. If I don't see you, take care. And thanks for hanging out with me tonight. Appreciate it. I will see you in a day or two. So take care, guys.